It's my pleasure to welcome you to the University of Manchester and the splendid surroundings of the Whitworth Hall at this graduation ceremony. In particular, I would like to welcome our graduands whose magnificent achievements and hard work we are here to celebrate on this day. We're also delighted to see so many friends and family here. We thank you for the support and encouragement you've given to our graduands during their studies, which has been so important to their success. Just like their tutors and members of staff in their schools and faculties, you can be extremely proud of what they've achieved. When those of you graduating today decided to study at the University of Manchester, you chose to make a major investment in your future, an investment that began to pay dividends as soon as you arrived. During your course of your studies, you'll have gained skills, knowledge to help you find success in future years. Although you might be glad to see the back of assignments, by the way, when I first started reading speeches that I'd written, I was about 22 years of age, and I read like this. Now I read a bit like this. The way you have balanced commitment to academic life with other interests and the many competing distractions of this great city of Manchester offers will help you find a work-life balance as your career and your future unfolds. And of course, we mustn't forget the strong, supportive friendships and relationships you've forged here, which I hope will sustain for many years to come. Put simply, your achievement in completing your degree cannot be overestimated for its value and the strong platform it gives you to build your career and achieve your goals. Manchester is already one of the finest cities in Europe, but we're determined to become one of the best in the world. With 160 nationalities on campus, the University of Manchester is already a truly global institution and one which will remain so, valuing its European and international staff, students, and alumni. And I hope that you fly from the University of Manchester being also able to appreciate that international perspective of the world. I believe that we're all immigrants. I migrated from my mother when I was born, from the womb into the open air. The last migration will be the breath from my body. Ideas migrate. Knowledge is a celebration of migration. At the very core of the new vision is major investment buildings, infrastructure and facilities, and a commitment to the highest standards in research and scholarship. Our ambitious plan is to lift Manchester into the first rank of virtuosity in higher learning. But it isn't the bricks, mortar, wires, technology, equipment, and pieces of paper that make this university so great and successful. It's our staff, our students, our people. During your studies, you've all, in your own way, enriched, shaped, and molded the University of Manchester. So the tremendous benefit of those who will follow in your footsteps. By reflecting on your experience and telling us how we could make them even better, you've given us the blueprint to achieve our bold ambitions to be among the best in the world. The university's changing, and will continue to change for the better because of you. Today is just as much about honouring you for this valuable contribution as for your success in your academic studies. So armed with your academic success, your skills, and your breadth of experiences, there's every reason to be positive about the future. Your job prospects, having studied here, are enviable because employers all around the world recognize the value of the piece of paper you will soon be holding in your hand. And by the way, if you are going to leave the university, and if you don't get a job immediately, the moment you step out of here, remember, that's okay. Okay, just remember that I said that now. That's okay. Obtaining your degree is a hugely important milestone, and you should, but if it happens, if it's taken 10 years, that's not okay, okay? Obtaining your degree is a hugely important milestone, and you should celebrate your success. But this is the beginning of the journey and your association with Manchester, not the end. The return on your investment continues way beyond today's pomp and ceremony. Our careers service continues to offer you help and support for 3 years, and you can continue to make good use of our world-class libraries. Do so, please. The Alumni Association will help you to remain in contact with the university, linking you with a community of more than 250,000 Manchester graduates living and working across the globe. As alumni, you can help future students in so many ways, as ambassadors of the university, in student placements and employment, and directly in the development of the university, which is vital to its future. So, we sincerely hope today will not be your last contact with the university, and remember that our doors will always be open to you, and most of all, take care of yourselves.
Chancellor, distinguished guests, and the graduands. It's my great privilege to address you on behalf of those of us on the stage, all dressed in our finery, who effectively have worked with you, have taught you, have helped you in your learning, and have learnt from you over your studies, because this is a learning environment, and it works both ways. We want to offer our congratulations to reinforce our Chancellor's remarks. Completing your studies, gaining your degree, is one of life's major achievements. It really is. It's the culmination of a huge amount of hard work, and you should take enormous satisfaction and pride from where you are today. Equally important, it's really important that we offer our congratulations also to those on, as I look on the left-hand side and at the back, the parents, the guardians, the families and the friends. Now more than ever, a university education requires huge amounts of commitment, not just from the students, but also from families and supporters in a variety of different ways. You've supported them, you know, financially, I'm sure, but practically, emotionally, very important. We know how proud you are today, and we know also through our tutees, through our students, through our students that we supervise, just how deeply they have appreciated the support and encouragement you provided over the course of their education, leading to this very special day today. So on behalf of the staff here and the graduands, many thanks for your support. So this is it. This is the last chance we get to say something to you, most of you. What do we want to say to you, our graduands? What do we want to say? Well, just a reminder, the university you're graduating from has three explicit goals. The first is world-class research, and equally outstanding learning and student experience. But the third is important as well, and that's a commitment to social responsibility. This third goal describes the way in which we as a university and all the people within it aim to make a difference to the social and economic well-being of our communities at all scales, from the local to the global, through our teaching, through our graduates, and through the wider impact of the research that we do here. We're distinctive in making such a very clear statement as an equal part of our three goals on that obligation. And of course, you're graduating from a school and from disciplines within that school, from the Global Development Institute, from Planning Environmental Management, from Geography, all have very direct connections to that agenda. Today, we predominantly, and with apologies to the undergraduates who were also graduating today, but predominantly today is a celebration of postgraduate study at master's and doctoral levels. And you're graduating, as we'll see in the programme, and you'll see when you're coming up onto the stage, the very wide range of programmes and subjects that you have studied. Examples include international development, development economics, planning, urban design and regeneration, real estate, environmental management, environmental governance and environmental monitoring, geographical information systems, and a wide range of PhD topic areas that you've undertaken. So there's a huge amount of variety in the school. There's a huge amount of variety in what you've undertaken over the last year or 3 years or so. But what we all share, what you all share, is a very direct connection and a very direct concern with the world that we aim to create. Through your studies and your work, you have sought to understand the causes of differences and inequalities between places and between social groups, the challenges of global development, the influence of planning and how we manage our resources, and the influence that can have on our environment. We're also being concerned with public policy and how we can feed into policy that changes things. So we all are interested in knowing, we are, but crucially, as very practical disciplines, we've also been committed and are committed to doing, to making a difference. So it's really unsurprising that in this school, the research that we undertake, there's a whole set of stories about the positive impacts of that on the wider world. Lots of examples, but just to pick a few examples from many of the contributions that the colleagues in front of you are making, both locally and, globally. Just three examples. A set of partnerships with the Peak District National Park, just to the east of Manchester, and the National Trust were there, have guided plans for the next 50 years for managing and conserving some of those environments, some of the nature's most precious landscapes. Work between planners and geographers in the school, with the help of architects as well, have developed a whole set of adaptation strategies for climate change in urban areas, working very closely with local councils and also working with international cities to adopt those approaches around the world. And the insights of researchers in the school have also helped companies, Cadbury's, now Mondelez, I know, but it's launched a £45 million cocoa partnership to support farmers and their communities and convert its range of products into fair trade. All where our research has had real impact on society and the wider environment. As a school, we've also had a couple of very important recent initiatives. We've launched two world-leading research centres in the last year or so. Some of you are graduating today from the Global Development Institute. You're the first graduates from that newly named institute. And it's playing a major role in supporting the university's commitment to addressing global poverty and inequality, and it's aiming to create and share knowledge to inform and influence policymakers, organisations and corporations. It's really wanting to try to make positive changes for people living in poverty. And just this month, about a week ago, we had the first of the launch of the Manchester Urban Institute. Cities and urban institutes, hugely important. Many issues in urban areas around the world, and they're emerging as key challenges to the future of our planet. So the research we do in those institutes and in our other research centres and groups is aiming to make a real difference to the wider world. And now back to you, because we know you've learned about that research and about its impacts in the studies that you've made. And many of you have contributed directly to that through your dissertation studies, focusing on these areas of expertise that we had, or you've led it through your doctoral studies. You've become research leaders in those areas. Which brings us to the main point of our address to you today. Our research is vital, there's no question about that. But the most profound influence that we have as a university and as individuals within that on the world is through you, our graduates. We know you go on to great things. We've seen that year after year in how well our alumni have done when they go on into careers. So we want to just finish our current association with you with two requests to you. The first is, whatever you do and whenever you go on into a career, we urge you to remember and take seriously the knowledge and the critical skills that you've gained, and to appreciate their significance. They're not commonplace. They really aren't. You now know stuff and have abilities that other people don't. You're a cosmopolitan, outward-looking and high-achieving bunch of people. And we know that you will take up increasingly influential positions in the UK, in Europe, worldwide. As researchers, as managers or teachers, some of you will become development practitioners, some of you will become planners, environmental managers. Many of you will step up to leadership positions in organizations and in government or NGOs or in private companies. But you will increasingly be in a powerful position to affect positive change, to envision, to inform, to shape our world. And this is really important. It's been an odd year, politically, in all sorts of ways. Do not become cynical in the face of all the talk this year about post-truth politics and the apparent dismissal of experts as key influencers of policy in the world. We and you need to robustly challenge that kind of thinking, those kind of attitudes. We do need critical, evidence-based leadership more than ever before, and of course, you are our future leaders. You're going to be the people who have that influence. So please value, communicate, and really promote your expertise. And then again, as our Chancellor said, we want you to keep in touch with Manchester. It's very important for us. On a personal level, there is nothing quite as rewarding as getting an email or a tweet or social media connection with students that we've taught in the past, even if it's 5, 10 years, 20 years down the line. It's extraordinarily rewarding to find out how you are doing and what you are achieving beyond your university education. But you'll know as well from the studies that you've done, all the disciplines that are graduating to here, it's terribly important that they continue to be outward facing and relevant. And we're increasingly using, and we need, the experience of past students who are in professional practice or business, in the policy sphere or lots of other fields that you populate. Because we need not just networking opportunities and placements, but we need advice from people out there. We need our courses to stay relevant. We need them to be connected to the challenges in the wider world and in policy. And in turn, if you stay connected with us, you will be, you know, you'll have the opportunity to interact with the students of the future who, you know, one day, who knows, they might be your employees 10 years down the line, maybe sooner than that. So, we very much hope that today's not the end of the association with us here in Manchester, but it's just a change in the nature of that relationship. Whatever you choose to do next, we're confident through your studies and your achievement, the world will be a more interesting place. And you are really well placed to head out there into the world and truly make a difference. And the most important thing is, you need to know how exceptionally proud of you all that we are. Thank you very much.
Chancellor, on behalf of the Senate of the University, I present to you for the degree of Doctor of Philosophy, Emmanuel Pompini Asante. Jemima Clark. Siyun Hang. Fortunate Machingura. Luis Eduardo Perez Mucia. Jacobus Renken. Kathy A. Wilcock. And for the degree of Master of Arts in International Development, Development Economics and Policy, Zheng Tao Gao. Jinyi Hong. Si Tong Hu. Sean Ilary Jones. Pierre Cedric Modua. Zhao Fei Sophie Song. And in development finance, Cheng Cheng. Zhao Di Gao. Yu Ying Ma. Daryl Huelin Clift Raymond. Jinjin Wang. Han Wu. Yang Zhao. Xuan Zhang. Zhang Zhang. Wan Zhu. And in international development, public policy and management, Shaista Bunyad. Yu Yao Chen. Stephanie Gil Conclaves de Morinda. Alexandra Fifi Huri Miguel. Hoi Min Lee. Yan Lang Liu. Esther Karimi Unjeru. Juan Carlos Reyes Quinteros. Rachel Louise Sadler. Bargos Suyanto. Poppy Hazel Anna Walter. Tong Wen. Yi Chen Ju. Hui Qian Yang. Yi Zhang. And in International Development, Globalization, Trade and Industry, Fatun Mustafa Abi Salam. Andrea Fladera. Hayu Giao. Shiki He. Kaining Zhang. Yunong Li. Kimeng. Grace Rigby. Fahima Udin. Shanshan Wang. Hui Wang Wu. Qin Yan Zhu. Wei Zhang. And in International Development, Governance and Policy, Ishita Bajpai. Natalie Grace Elizabeth Collins. Eileena Schulenberg. Febi Risti Wadianto. And in International Development Management, Glorima Abreu. Ji Huang. Wei La. Yaki Liang. Sarah Mosen Machmuchi. Nikki Ayu Prawitya. Shi Aiku. Kai Yu Zhang. Su Ying Zhang. And in International Development, Policy and Inequality, Anna Elizabeth Baldwin. Elena Maria Caballero Cale. Benjamin Christopher James Doherty. Lydia Abigail Entwistle. Cassopia Hudson. Helen Del Rocio Lopez Valderas. Marwa Makbul Malik. Amna Rana. Sophie Maria Smulders. Tyre Wood. And in International Development, Poverty, Conflict and Reconstruction, Antonia Rose Chapelo. Valentine Wangi Ngure. Yasmin Abdelhalim Osman. Imad Salma. Catherine Alicia Olafemi Taylor. Jamo van Lutterveld. Rachel Ward Newton. Dina Weinstein. And in International Development, Environment, Climate Change and Development, Shahid Keith Chowdhury. Ya Jong Liu. Mariana Octaviana Siliane. And in International Development, Alina Agha. Temi Tope Olawatoyun Balogun. Henry Alexander Barnick. Rebecca Catherine Butcher. Catherine Chavieski. Alice Porter Cross. Megan D'Souza. Fiona Michelle Amondi Akwiri. Adrian Michael O'Sullivan. Sh- Tristi Thiapati. Jack Theodore Snoddy. Helen Swarbrick.
Chancellor, on behalf of the Senate of the University, I present to you, for the degree of Doctor of Philosophy, Alexandra Buckland Wright. Dawn Nicola Cole. Melissa Garcia Lamarca Williams. Thank you. And for the degree of Master of Science in Geographical Science, and also awarded the best student on this course and a highly commended dissertation, Amy Catherine Barron. And for the MSc in Environmental Monitoring, Modelling and Reconstruction, also awarded a highly commended dissertation, Luke Bowman. And with a highly commended dissertation, Alexander William Boland. Now, for the best performance on the MSc in Environmental Monitoring, Modelling and Reconstruction, and a highly commended dissertation, Sarah Brown. Kai-Sing Huang. And with a highly commended dissertation, Samuel John William James. Also with a highly commended dissertation, Elliot James Petty. Ki Ren. And for the MSc in Environmental Governance, and the best Environmental Governance student with a highly commended dissertation, Alexandra Cuscieri. Xiaofen Zhang. And for the MSc in Geographical Information Science, and also awarded a highly commended dissertation, Kuhu Dahira. And also with a highly commended dissertation, Ethan Joshua Hayes. And with a highly commended dissertation, Shrabanti Hira. Yang Jen Ho. Qinshan Li. Ruchi Song. And for the postgraduate diploma in Geographical Information Science, Bhattadeni Demadbal. And for the postgraduate certificate in Geographical Information Science, Nahira Ghazinejad. And for the degree of Bachelor of Arts in Geography with Honours, Shamiso Chimbo. Kazimir Ovid Sikaya. And in Geography with International Study, with honours, Max Corral. And for the degree of Bachelor of Science in Geography, with honours, Martina Talaccia.
Chancellor, on behalf of the Senate of the University, I present to you for the Doctor of Philosophy, Sara Ali Mohammed Abdulmohan Hassan. Taki Sombly. And for the degree in Environmental Impact Assessment and Management, Safia Bibi. And with a highly commended dissertation, William Patrick James Chance. Also with a highly commended dissertation, Svetlana Cronin. And again, highly commended dissertation, Katie Dixon. And highly commended dissertation again, Ned Fisi. And a highly commended dissertation, but also awarded the Norman Lee Prize, the Haywood Medal, and the Wardell Armstrong Prize, Thomas James Gold. And with a highly commended dissertation, Edward Hargreaves. And a highly commended dissertation, Fumiya Hayashi. Ying Jong Han. David McFarlane. Samuel James Oliver. And with a highly commended dissertation, Dania Bashir Mahmoud Shahid. Si Chi Su. Xiao Yu Wang. Yimin Xu. Jai Shishi Jiang. And in Global Urban Development and Planning, Ambuj Kumar. Yang Jing Zhou. Of the MSc in Planning, Anne Charlotte Daniels. Zi Yun Han. And for a highly commended, the award for a highly commended dissertation, Lauren James Hargreaves. Kate Elizabeth Lowe. Adam Paul Murray. Katie Victoria Parfitt. And for a highly commended dissertation, William Partington. And for that highly commended dissertation, Georgina Ann Redpath. Holly Roberts. And also for a highly commended dissertation, Jenna Wilkes. Robbie Wilson. And I think it's for the Urban MSc in Urban Regeneration and Development. And also awarded the RTPI Prize, that's the Royal Town Planning Institute Prize, and the highly commended dissertation, Thomas James Arnold. And awarded the Holiday Prize for the most outstanding performance in the final year, and the highly commended dissertation, Amy Beasley. Yu Chen. Caitlin Megan Dixon. Jingyang Guo. Meng Hui Li. Hyun Li. And also highly commended for their dissertation, James Peter Warrington. Duncan John Wenham. Dai Jung Wu. Biwen Jiang. And for the MSc in Real Estate Development, with a highly commended dissertation, Olan Coyle. And also highly commended for their dissertation, Andrew Edward Thomas Keeley. Daniel James Lawrenson. Kieran Ronan Vincent McGivney. Emma Louise Pratt. Michael Nathan Shaw. Tejal Singh. Finlay Andrew Shield Tate. And for the MSc in Real Estate Asset Management, with a highly commended dissertation, Erin Chard. Sue Gao. Jamie Harry Gordon. Ricardo Abel Gutierrez Inostroza. And with a highly commended dissertation, Shouwei Huang. Nikki Chi Ching Lee. Jing Li. Lei Li. Chao Lin. Cheng Zi Lin. Si Yu. Rupert Christian St. John Madden. Jun Tian. V. Hong Chuong. Liu Wang. Hong Jiao.
Lin Zhao.
And for the MSc in Urban Design and International Planning, Yuting Cheng. And with a highly commended dissertation, Martha Carolina Gomez Moreira. And with a highly commended dissertation, Joseph Greaves. Ru Li. Anna Kashfi Binti Muhammad. Elazar P. Rakoma. And with a highly commended dissertation, Raisya Sylvia Sembriring. Andreas Siantos. And with a highly commended dissertation, Daniel Strode. Charles Ewan William Wright. Jing Xu. And Jia Jing.
On behalf of the university, I once again congratulate all of you who are graduating here today on your excellent achievements, and I wish you every success and happiness in your future lives and careers and today. I now declare the ceremony open. I now declare the ceremony closed.